Okay, and you've had nothing to drink tonight, sir?
No, sir.
Okay, why don't you just step outside of the car for a second, sir? Okay. Just step back here with me for a second, sir. All right, sir, you're being placed under arrest tonight. DWI, you've had a little bit too much to drink. All right, sir?
I think people from other countries who may not have the jail requirement and come here would be an eye-opener because people who are not used to this corrective action that we use here in the U.S. Would probably be quite a shock to most people.
Is that red car?
Living on spawn cake, watching the sun bake. All of those tourists covered in oil.
Don't drink and drive is the slogan in the United States. But what happens if you don't obey the law? The worst nightmare for any tourist is to be arrested and taken to jail for DWI. The blood alcohol limit in the United States is at 0.08. However, if you, for example, get stopped for driving too fast, running a stop sign or red light, you can get arrested and go to jail at a blood alcohol level of 0.03. You can only leave jail after 6 hours of mandatory jail time when someone bails you out by paying a $500 cash bond. Otherwise, you have to stay in jail for 48 hours.
It's our own damn fault.
In some places, you might have to stay for longer than 48 hours because you would have to have somebody to come and bail you out. A lot of courts would be reluctant to allow someone out on what's called their own recognizance if they were from a foreign country. They're even reluctant to do that if you're from another state because it's difficult for the police then to try to go after you if you don't show up for court. And so it's possible that someone could stay in jail for quite a long time.
And when you're arrested and you go to jail, you go to booking, they do have to fingerprint you, they take the mug shots with your numbers and whatnot. They make you take off all your clothes and your jewelry, and they put you in these orange suits with these little flip-flop shoes. And then they have you sit, I guess, on these benches or on the floor. I don't know how many people they have, depending on that.
Can you understand me? Can you understand what I'm saying?
Right.
Okay.
We take an extra step further to try to help people out that don't speak English. First, we try to obtain what country they're from. And again, find out the embassy numbers. Most people who are here will know the embassy numbers just because they know that that might be a source of help at any given time. But we do allow the extra phone calls for a national who's here visiting.
Unit 11, mass control.
I arrested a German tourist, and she was very... she did not understand why she was being arrested and did not understand the laws of New Mexico, why she was being placed into handcuffs and taken to the jail. I believe she was very scared at the time that she was arrested and did not know what was going on at the time, and it was a very scary part of her life.
If I was a tourist in the United States from another country and if the cops were to stop me and pull me over for drinking and driving, I wouldn't know what to do. And it's like now even when I got my DWI, I barely knew what to do. I had a lot of friends that I talked to and everything and recommended I got a lawyer, because if I wouldn't, they're gonna eat me alive. And
I would absolutely recommend getting a lawyer if you get caught with DWI, particularly for someone who does not live in the United States, because that person is not going to be familiar with the court system, and there are also added problems that relate to immigration status, deportation, and considerations like that. That you really need to have a lawyer to help you with.
Very few DWIs will cost you less than $2,000 by the time you're done.
Including DWI school and my lawyer, the interlock, the DWI screening, also the counseling costed me because I had to pay for that, victim impact panel, the loss of my truck, and also the hospital bills because they didn't get covered from my insurance. So the total estimate was like $37,000.
More and more jurisdictions in the United States are enacting laws that allow the government to confiscate a vehicle when someone is in some cases even charged with a DWI. So basically what that means is that even if someone has an expensive car, if they get a DWI in a jurisdiction that allows for the confiscation of vehicles, the person could lose their car to the government, whatever the state or local government is, even if it's a very expensive car.
If there's one can of beer, say you're driving around in a car and one person has a beer, and there's five people in the car, all five are technically guilty of that one open container. It doesn't matter if you're drinking from it or not, if you knew it was in the car or not, that is the violation. And the penalty can be up to 90 days in jail and a $500 fine.
You have a message waiting at the paging assistant.
A warrant can be indefinite. It doesn't have any expiration date. So if you have a warrant that you left for Germany or some other country for quite a few years, 10 years, let's say, and you come back to New Mexico, they run your personal information. If you get stopped, the warrant will still be there because you still have failed to appear on the original charge.
One of the consequences that can happen for someone who is a tourist or not a United States citizen when they get a DWI is that they can be deported.
If you are involved in immigration or naturalization, please inform the court so I can best advise you of your rights and opportunities.
I need four fingers, just like this. Okay, both thumbs, and then four fingers over here. There you go. You've been fingerprinted.
Okay, regarding fingerprints of every person who is arrested for a DWI or a DUI, fingerprints are used on what we term a life scan machine. Those entries are made through the FBI and through the Department of Public Safety. The fingerprints are disseminated out to all the various agencies, and it does go federal once it reaches the FBI. They do have and maintain those records.
And if you've ever been arrested and fingerprinted, that once you're fingerprinted, that's submitted to the FBI. So whether you were visiting New Mexico for one night and then went to Germany and didn't come back for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, your fingerprint will still be on file.
Well, I think that it's hard to say right now exactly what the consequences of that would be, because the immigration laws have changed so much ever since the attack on the World Trade Center on September 11th of 2001. I think it would be fair to say that there's a good chance that they're that someone would either be denied entry into the country or they would be admitted into the country and then arrested and taken to the court where they had not shown up.
I think it's enough maybe to say I'm never going to drink again. Yeah.
You know, just the other night the cops pulled me over outside the bar. Well, they turned on their lights and they ordered me out of my car. Man, I was only kidding when I called them a couple of dicks. But still they made me do the stupid human tricks. Now I'm stuck in this jail with a bunch of dumb hicks. And I still don't know. I am, man.
Right now, 19 of weapons and drugs. No? Maybe not that you know.